Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Today's series on the childhood of the Prophet Muhammad. The first thing that we know of his life after his birth is the fact that his mother gave him to be raised in the desert. In fact, this was a custom of the elite of Quraysh. Now you all know the story of Halima, the foster mother of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are just going to summarize it briefly. Halima bint Sa'idah, the famous foster mother of the Prophet, she narrates this story in this first person, and it is directed and recorded in number of books of hadith and seerah and so on. It is an authentic hadith, no doubt about that, that she said that she and her husband were suffering greatly from poverty. So she is explaining why would she want to take another baby, because that baby gets money, the parents gives money, and so I convinced my husband to go with that yearly. There was an yearly time that the woman of Banu Sa'd Ibn Bakr would go to Mecca and would obtain any newly born child who would be waiting to be foster fed for 2 to 3 years. So she goes with that group, probably 5-10 women from her clan, and they enter into Mecca and they find out that who has given birth, and they hear of the newest batch that has come forth in the last 5 to 6 or 7 months. One of them, of course, is the child that is called as an orphan child. They were told immediately there was an orphan child, his father is already dead. Some of the women didn't even go visit the house of Amina, because the only reason you would adopt a child who is an orphan, and when the child is an orphan, then it's known that you are not getting to get that much money after all. I mean, where you can get from an orphan child? Others went, and when they saw how poor and the poverty, they didn't like taking child who was orphan. Halima as well visited, and she tried to move on to find another child because she wanted the money. When that week finished, every one of her friends had acquired one of these newborn child except for Halima, and the only child remaining was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She told her husband that I feel embarrassed. It's like a bit shameful that all of my friends are going back now to the desert and they have a child and I don't have any. It seems like this, I'm lost. I mean, it's not fair, meaning I want to be like them. Why don't you take the orphan child? Perhaps Allah will bless us through him. So they agreed to take care of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All the narration said that as soon as they took the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the miracles began right then and there. That she only had only one goat that had stopped giving milk, but as soon as Prophet entered the house, the goat's udder becomes full. She had only one mount that they were riding, the both of them, and when they put the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam along with that family on the ride on this animal, it became, you know, the foster care usually lasted 2 years. During these 2 years, the blessings that Halima witnessed in her household were so many that she was scared of losing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and so she invented a million and one excuses in front of Amina. She kept on persisting until Amina felt that there was no so much care and love that a Prophet would get, and so she agreed to extend this contract for a longer period. Of course, it was during the second phase of the foster care that the famous incident of the opening of the heart occurred. When the Prophet was 4 years old, Anas ibn Malik narrates the hadith in Sahih Muslim. So this is an authentic hadith, no question about it, that Jibreel came and all children were playing. The other children, when Jibreel came, other children ran away. They scared. The Prophet stood on his ground only. As a 4 years kid, he is displaying the bravery, and but Jibreel overpowered him. This means that he was struggling. A 4 years kid is fighting like an with the angel, and the strongest angel Allah has created, but he is not going to go without a fight. Again, this shows the determination of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Jibreel forced him on the ground. You can't fight Jibreel. He forced him on the ground. He opened up his chest, just two words, and he took his heart out, and he took out black portion, a slither portion from the heart of the Prophet Muhammad, and he threw it away. So he said, this is the shaitan's portion that he had in you. He took it out, and then he washed the heart in golden cup of zamzam, and then he put it back. So he washed the heart and he put it back and he sealed it up. So when the children, the foster brother and the Shaima who he was playing with, when the children ran away, they ran back and they said that they are looking in the distance, that there is a man throwing him on the floor, putting blood into this and that. Our brother has been killed, a man has abducted him, a man has killed him. And of course Halima and others, they became so worried, they come running outside and they found that Prophet sitting over there, not wailing, not screaming, not crying. He is the brave, he is the bravest 4 years old world has ever seen. And when they saw him, they saw those lines on his chest, and I could see the traces of that line of the chest. The honest Anas is narrating that hadith when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is around 50-60 years old. This incident was what concerned Halima, and so she decided before anything else happens, and let me quietly return the Prophet to Amina. So shortly after the Prophet was returned to Amina, we only have one incident that is recorded during this time. Amina decided to take her son to Yathrib, means today's Medina, and she had with her the only one servant that it is said that Abdul Muttalib gifted them when they got married, and this is Ummi Ayman. Abdul Muttalib gifted his son, and so Amina traveled to Yathrib, which is now called Medina, along with the Ummi Ayman and the little boy. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Prophet stayed there for a few months, and on the way back in this small little settlement which is still present on this day, and it is called Al Abwa. Amina herself fell ill, she passed away right there and then, and Ummi Amin had her buried by the people of the village of Abwa. And so this day her grave is the place called as the Abwa. And when the Prophet is barely 6 years old, he loses his mother and his father, so he is then entrusted to Abdul Muttalib, the grandfather, the chieftain of the Quraysh. In one occasion, the uncles of the Prophet sent the Prophet to find some lost camels. Ibn Sa'd mentioned the reason why his uncle chose a little kid, because he is probably 7 or 8 years old, to find the camels was because, listen to this, he never did anything except that it was successful. So now the uncles are getting desperate, camels are expensive, courageous, the uncle are getting desperate and they can't find the camels, so they decide, well, this boy, whatever he does, it works. Let's go send him out alone in the desert to find the camels. And when they sent the Prophet, he was delayed in coming back. And Abdul Muttalib, when he found that, he was furious at them. How could you have done this? Why did you send the boy? Now, of course, they sent him. The Abdul Muttalib was furious and he was pacing and walking around waiting for the Prophet to come. And as soon as he came, he hugged him and he said, now from on, I will never let you out of my sight. As we all know, at the age of 8, once again for the third time, our Prophet became an orphan. First the father, then his mother, and now his grandfather. And one of the things that Abdul Muttalib did on his deathbed is that he entrusted the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to his son Abu Talib. And so Abu Talib takes the charge of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Abu Talib lives a long life thereon. And Abu Talib passes away when the Prophet is over 50 years old, so he remains with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam till eternity. So this is about the childhood of the Prophet Muhammad. Tomorrow we will see the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as an. Till that time, like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you very much.